Again, more notes. These ones aren't. Good morning! So, a lot of things changed since the last time I made a video. First of all, I changed houses, but more importantly and more excitingly, if that's a word, I changed jobs. As you can probably already tell from the title, I am currently doing or finishing up my internship at Microsoft, which is something that I've always thought of. Well, no, that's a lie. I didn't always think about it because I didn't think that that's the sort of thing that I can do. At least not until like a few years later in my life path plan. But things like this happen like that, I guess, when you're not really necessarily planning it or expecting it. And it's been a really, really crazy journey. And I can talk a bit more about how it happened in another video. But for today, I just wanna take you with me for one of my last days and show you kinda what I do as an intern and what just a day in the office looks like. And I hope you enjoy it. So one of the reasons that I picked today is because there's a conference in the US, or two conferences in the US happening right now. So most of the people in the office are going there, which means that it's really quiet. So it's a bit less awkward to film myself. And it also means that I can sit in the really fancy rooms today. So this one's available. We're gonna go. And they have this kind of homey living room feel, and I'm going to be working over here. I'm preparing for my Azure Fundamentals exam. Again, more notes. These ones aren't fully read this time. That's a certification that anyone can get online from any country anywhere, and we don't have to. But I thought it would be a nice wrap up of everything that I did and everything that I studied to say, okay, I kind of know how things work now. It's not very technical. It's more about getting used to Azure as a platform for the cloud and the kind of products that are on it. But during the summer, I also want to do the data science associate and the AI engineer, which are a lot harder. But yeah, it's kind of funny. I kind of took a break from school to focus on this, but that doesn't mean that I'm not still learning all the time. So that's still really exciting. So I thought I would take another minute to have a quick explanation of a few more things. It's not a very busy day, but I do have a few things to do, so I'm gonna do these little vlog moments in between. So a little bit about Microsoft in the Netherlands, as opposed to the one that everyone kind of knows, which is Redmond. Our organization is a bit more sales focused. We don't create Microsoft products, but we help clients implement them, and we help them with their questions, and we help them develop their own solutions on top of the Azure platform or on top of other Microsoft products. And I keep saying cloud because I work in the cloud area with Azure. That's where a lot of the data and AI things are happening, but also normal software engineering things. But there's of course other areas as well. People work with devices or with the Office 365 packet, or a lot of different other Microsoft services. Of course, it's a very wide range of products. But for myself, I focus on data science solutions.
Hello. Okay, so that was kind of it for the day. It's been a pretty short day today, not that much to do since, like I said, I'm going on holiday in 2 days and I'm probably gonna work from home tomorrow. So this is my last official day in the office as an intern. That's really weird to think about. But yeah, so next month of August, I'm going to be working from Romania still as an intern since I extended my internship. And then from September onwards, I actually have a new role as an Aspire trainee, which is the old match program thing. That's an international thing. It happens in the US as well. But for us, it's now rebranded as the Aspire program. And it's kind of like a 2-year traineeship, which you're not really an intern, but you're not really an employee yet. You're kind of an employee with training wheels and less responsibility. So that's really exciting as well, and I love that I get to continue working for this company for another 2 years, or maybe no more, who knows. And I get to explore more of the Microsoft offices, hopefully in other countries as well, and I will try to, as much as possible, share a bit about it. Because I remember when I went to my interview, I looked online for any information that I can find, but most of everything was focused around Redmond and around the US Microsoft, which is completely different than the experience that I've had. I didn't have to do a coding interview, I didn't have to answer software engineering questions. So it was quite different, and the roles are different as well. So I thought it would be useful to have some resources for non-US Microsofts and to show what it's like internationally. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I am finishing off in yet another room. I really like the fact that you can switch around and always have like a different work experience. It keeps things interesting and exciting. And I hope you found this video interesting and exciting. And I'm going to go home now and then enjoy my holiday.